dogs, and Angel Heart make their appearances known to Harry Angel, and many of them just don't like what they see in him. Are they theatrical props, or do they represent a deeper, more sinister meaning that may shake your very fears and insecurities? In this video, we explore every appearance of the canine, their importance and significance. But fair warning, it does come with a major spoiler for anyone who has not yet read the source material. Angel Heart was released in 1987, written and directed by Alan Parker, and based on the novel Falling Angel by William Hjortsberg. When Angel steps out of his car, prepared to break into Dr. Fowler's house, there are barking dogs heard in the background. They are calling for him, almost knowing what he was up to. It may seem coincidental, but nothing in film and sound editing are coincidental. Angel locks Fowler in his bedroom, hoping a nap of cold turkey will rekindle his memories of Johnny Favorite. Walking past a dilapidated church, his feet through the snow, the barking dogs have returned. They never left, still waiting, still taunting him. It's the spirits of dogs actively looking for him into the night. After a meeting over boiled eggs with Lewis Cyphre, Angel returns to the Kingdom Mission, discovers Pastor John's business secrets, bumps into the Lady in Black, and is attacked by heavies. He escapes outside, and the sounds of barking dogs return. Angel races across the street and interrupts the pastor's procession, and he races along a chain-linked fence where four dogs furiously yap at him. The chain-link fence is more like a window, separating Angel, keeping him safe from being torn apart. But now the dogs know who he is and what he looks like. Driving deeper into the bayou, Angel makes his way to Evangeline's grave. He takes a dirt road through rural Louisiana. From a distance, the dogs recognize Angel. Even leashed, they want to go after him. When Angel makes it to Evangeline's burial site, Epiphany comes to pay tribute. Harry hides. With the serene sounds of chirping birds comes a subtle reminder of dogs again. When he is tempted to get too close to Epiphany, Angel steps into Epiphany's courtyard in his clever disguise. A canine leaps out at him. It startles Angel, and he runs out of its reach. The leash and chain gives. While other dogs bark and whine, this one seems to be on the attack. Further into the story, well past Angel's scuffle with Tut Sweet and his discovery of Margaret's heartbroken body, Angel is tailed by Ethan Krusmark's hired men. His attempt to play another character out of his wallet doesn't work when a pit bull is released on Harry and grabs him by the leg. Harry can't fight it off and joins the crawfish in the water. Since these are Krusmark's men, it's safe to assume this is Krusmark's dog, and this fact is an important clue I'll reveal later. Angel walks through the town. Off camera comes the repeated barks of a dog, angry at Angel's presence. The barking annoys Harry, and he decides to confront Krusmark's henchmen, still waiting for him to catch the next train. There's violence in the stables, and the pit bull is released just as the moment Angel is pinned underneath a horse. But a stroke of good luck saves Harold, and Angel escapes through a tunnel filled with live chickens. Before we reveal the sad meaning of dogs, like, share, or subscribe if you enjoy this content and want to see more like this one. Most every frame in the film is an experience seen through Angel's eyes or otherwise within earshot. One exception, debatable in its severity, where Angel in his car drives across New Orleans and catches the attention of a resident and, of course, her dogs. However, the biggest, most obvious is the film's opening, showcasing a devilish man with a cane described in the script, whistling a familiar tune. We, the audience, hear as Girl of My Dreams by Saxophone. What else do we see? A recent murder, a cat, but most of all, a dog. The film introduces a world with death everywhere and no hairy angel. Why would the dogs in Angel's world seem to know something he does not? The clues are found in Ethan Krusmark's testimony told to Angel describing the sacrificial ritual performed by Johnny Favorite. The victim, a young soldier, was bound naked on a rubber mat, a pentacle branded on his chest, and Johnny was handed a virgin dagger and sliced the victim clean open and woofed down his heart. While that and contents from a broken vase tells us things, the film never answered one curious question. Whatever happened to the victim's body? The source material, Falling Angel by Hjortsberg, gives us this answer. When Angel confronts Krusmark, the film is rather faithful to the book as far as dialogue and information shared to the reader. However, in the novel, Angel asked what happened to the body. Krusmark answered, it was dismembered and fed to the dogs, Krusmark's dogs, from one of his kennels. While the dialogue and the piece of trivia about Angel's body are omitted from the film, the dogs and the symbolisms remain as sad and depressing as it was. Let me know in the comments below, had you ever given thought about the dogs through the film? And would you think differently now, the next time you watch Angel Heart? This is Mr. G of Synergy saying, sometimes it's best to leave town on the next train. Check out other videos on the channel. Thanks for watching.